Well, another day of Ellerslie comes to a close, and it's been a great day. The sun has been shining, the rain has disappeared, and we're looking forward to tomorrow, Sunday, the last day of Ellerslie for 2014, and it's going to be the best day weather-wise we've had all week as well. So make sure you come down. The gates are open at 10 o'clock, and when you get here, well, there's so many gardens and designers to check out. Let's go and catch up with a few now.
This will be my sixth Ellerslie, including 2011 when the earthquakes were on. We're halfway through there, so yeah, some old piece of furniture here at Ellerslie. I love the people coming around and giving me good feedback, and I was really disappointed, as you're probably aware, with what I got this year. And judges gave me good and bad feedback, so I'm trying to take that into account. But I'll definitely be back again, without a doubt. Just the camaraderie of everyone and the staff people, and once again, you guys who are awesome. So yeah, I just love it. Ellerslie Junkie, and love talking to people, and my passion about my Australian outback theme. Garden's a mix between, it's called my outback oasis. So it's outback and it's my oasis, which is at the back of the garden with the ferns and the waterfall. So it's just it's me bringing a little bit of Australia to Hagley Park, and everything was sourced here pretty much. So red brick dust from Darfield, and my sponsors are really, really great. So just showcasing Australia, and putting that big crocodile in there just brings it to life as well. There's a few turtles floating around in there as well. So every 6 o'clock they come and grab some mints, so I know where they are. And then they take off for the day again. So yeah, it's a real cultural experience, and I love talking to people about it because they're really interested in obviously getting a little bit of a media attention with it through the awards is, yeah, just giving me really good feedback from the public. I don't know, you know how we apparently take everything from you guys and claim Pavlova and stuff like that. So a bit of that, they're not believing that they're Australian ferns and whatnot. So, but it's all a good banter, and you know, why did you bring this red dust over from Australia, you lunatic? And so yeah, it's just really great. Yeah, have to tell people it's not an alligator and it's a crocodile. Alligators in America, crocodiles in Australia. So. Yeah, it's just good, nice, fun banter, and yeah, love it. Love to bring people onto the garden too. You get a different sense of it with the Aboriginal artwork. It's just a real cultural experience.
I came back to Ellerslie this year to just showcase what we have been experiencing for the last 2 years with our organisation, and just to show people what they could do at home on a larger scale from the last time. So my garden design's called Perennial Paradise. And as you can see, everything that's planted in the garden is perennial. So it's perennial plantings of fruit trees, berries, herbs, medicinal herbs, a lot of rhubarb and spinach, and a lot of perennial vegetables. Something that can go in once and the gardener doesn't have to take care of every year. The reaction's been varied from the feedback that we've got. A lot of people are blown away that it's a shipping container that's been recycled and reused again. They can't believe that it has, because it looks so good. We've had lots of people really interested in the plantings and being able to recreate those at home as well. A lot of the plantings have you know, multiple uses, so for shade and different things as well. So we've had amazing feedback. It's been really good.
Well, my garden this year is about, what is it about? It's about family, really. I felt that I've worked really hard every year to create a garden that I've wanted to do, to make it really beautiful and to win gold medals and to do all those sorts of things. And this year, I guess I felt that each year my family, my children, my wife, they've kind of missed out, and they've often haven't seen me for about a month while I've been setting up. So this year I actually wanted to include them all. And so my son came up with the idea of a bed that would rise up and go up into a tree. And my daughter wanted one that she could lie down and read a book on, and my wife was keen on having something that could sit up. So we made little wee balsawood models that could kind of fold down and up, and checking out the weight distribution and things on them. We did all of that together as a family, and we built most of the garden, the parts of the garden at home, and so they all helped me do that as well. It was hard actually putting it together. I wasn't sure how it would come together, and it's such an abstract thing, a tree. It's a really difficult structure to work with, to plan with. I mean, I've been so lucky to have this tree, and I wanted to make the tree to be the focus of the design, not my work, so that my work simply accentuates the tree, the beauty of the tree. The tree that I hadn't really noticed that much before, but now I look at it, I really love it. And the more time I spend with it, the more I enjoy it. And I think the tree has made the exhibit for me. For someone who hasn't been to the show yet, I think there's a few really core things that I'd want to see. Obviously this one, this is amazing, and if you can come for a ride on one of those seats, because it is quite fun, especially if you've got kids. But I'm right beside Ben Hoyle's garden, and I love his garden. It's just so serene. And Sally's garden, the pink garden, just brings tears to my eyes. I'm not really any good with colour, and she is. She's amazing with it. And seeing her setting it all up, and just her passion for colour has been amazing. But the one that's probably closest to my heart is the Botanic Gardens exhibit that they won Supreme Award this year. And I just, that sort of use of texture and foliage and structure is something that I really relate to.
I could really see this being in our garden back home. How about you? Dan Rutherford, just one of the many wonderful gardens here at Ellerslie this year. So the gates open at 10 o'clock. It's the last day of Ellerslie. Make sure you come down and check out all the gardens and the designers. But there's so much to see and do as well. There is Smeg Edible Ellerslie. There's the fashion tent as well. There's Hort Galore, Floral Art, and of course Jenny Gillies that people are just raving about. So tomorrow, the final day. Don't miss it. We'll see you then.